What's up, YouTube? So I have an iPhone 5S here that's hanging out on iOS 10.3.2, I believe. And it's feeling kind of lonely since the iOS 11 jailbreak is going to drop. I have SHSH blobs for this device. I have them for all my devices. And I'm going to perform an upgrade from iOS 10.3.2 to iOS 11.1.2, which isn't being signed anymore. And I'm going to use this, or do this, using the Vortex nonce enabler and basically going to use the Prometheus downgrade method to upgrade my device to iOS 11 without having to go to the latest firmware. So I wanted to make a video to show you guys how I'm going to do this. Hopefully this will help you out. The iOS version number really doesn't matter here as long as the version that you're downgrading to works with the latest SEP. So because I'm going to iOS 11.12, iOS 11.21 SEP will work on 11.12. If I try to go backwards to 10.3 again, I would need to use the over-the-air, the OTA 10.33 blobs, which are still being signed by Apple, but that only works for certain devices. So if you have an iPhone like 6, 6S, and 7, this is not going to work for you. But it will work for the older devices. And if you're going from iOS 10.2 to iOS 11.12 on like the iPhone 6S and stuff like that, it would work. So first thing we're going to need to do is download FutureRestore and Vortex nonce. Now the links will be in the description for these. Both of them are on GitHub here. And to download them, just hit the clone download. You'll get a zip file. Make sure that you unzip each one of these. So the first thing we need to do is set the nonce. Now before we do this, we need to know what that nonce is going to be set to. So I have my SHSH blob in FutureStore's folder already. We're going to need this for restoring. Wherever yours is, it's probably best that you put it in this folder just to follow along. To view the nonce generator, the code that we need, you'll have to open this using the handy text app. And if you scroll partway down, might be a little more than partway, right here, you'll find the code that we need, and I've actually copied this over here already. And then before we really begin, you'll want to download the iOS 11.12 for the device that you're choosing to downgrade. In this case, I'm downgrading the 5S, or upgrading, downgrading, restoring. So the next thing we need to do is set the nonce. So we need to open this project here. So we had some issues there, but once the project finally loads up, you need to head over to the top here and set your team, and then also change the build identifier to something unique. Make sure your device that you want to downgrade is plugged in. And click build. Now we'll see it open up here. And actually, if you read here, you can see that I've already set the nonce on this. And it tells us what it's currently generating. To set this on the device here, you just tap this set generator. And then you would type in the nonce. So I could actually type in, make sure you get this right, 0x97, and so on. You guys can see here, I've put in the correct one. So once you're completed with that, you can actually close the Xcode. Leave your device running. You can just go back to your home screen and you can actually close Xcode completely. Sometimes the task likes to hang. Now, the next thing you'll want to do, now that you've downloaded the firmware you want to downgrade to or upgrade to, you'll want to put that in the Future Restore folder. And then this is where you're going to want to copy down this command, and you'll want to have an open notepad for this, because what you need to do is basically copy the name of your nonce. So you want to run the program. The ticket will be your SHSH blob. You want to use the latest baseband, the latest SEP, and then you're directing it to restore this firmware. So the device is still plugged in. The first thing you need to do is open up a terminal window. And you can do this by searching in your Spotlight terminal. First thing you'll want to do is go CD to your location, which you can probably and then if you type in ls you can see all the files that are there. So we want to make sure these three files are available, because that's what we're going to be restoring to. So now we can copy over what we created here, and now we're just going to run the command. And we'll allow the device to restore. If your device doesn't enter recovery mode properly, reboot the device and then rerun the command. Now this is going to take a little while, so we're just going to let it load. And we can see here that we have a successful upgrade, downgrade, whatever you want to call it. And we can see the device is rebooting here. And so now we are on iOS 11.1.2. And we will be able to jailbreak this device. So I will make a spot on this for my webpage, or on my webpage for this. I'll improve the tutorial. Obviously, you guys have this video. If you have any questions, make sure you ask me in the comments below. We'll just wait it for it to boot up here, and then I will show you guys that it actually is iOS 11.12. Stay tuned. Alright guys, so after my restore here, I just want to show you that the Touch ID is working. And we can go through, make sure. So Touch ID did allow me to do that. We'll just set a whatever password, you betcha. Alright, so now we'll just quickly jump into settings here. I skipped through the last little bit. And here we go. And why not? You guys can see the baseband there. And we have a fully working iOS 11.12, which we can now jailbreak. Awesome. All right, guys, I hope this helps you and allows you to upgrade your jailbroken device if you choose to jump on the latest jailbreaks. So this also means if you're on like a 10.2 and you held off because you didn't believe a jailbreak was going to ever come out, and one actually does come out, then you can move up. So it was a good idea to stay where you were. You weren't missing out on anything, and that just goes to show that holding off and not updating your device is always the best way to go. Thanks for watching this, guys. I hope this tutorial helps you out. Share it with your friends. Share it with everybody who's been saving their SHSH blobs. This is why you save your SHSH blobs. Very important. Thanks for watching, guys. See you again next time.